Welcome back to another precision farming video. So, it's about time to do a follow-up video on everything I've learned so far. Now we've got nitrogen is what I'm looking at. I'm going to zoom in this field here with my worker on it, worker H. I'm looking at this light green, which is at about 160, 140. This is 180, this is 200. Because of the soil types, this being loam, this being sandy loam. What I'm really looking at here is how the nitrogen has really gotten splotchy, which is interesting. And that is because I'm looking at rotation plan A. Since I started this precision farming series, I plotted out brand new from the grass, fresh, planted wheat on it after that, and then I harvested canola after the wheat, and then next I went with oats, and then I went with wheat. So we've got one, two, three harvested crops and one that I'm planting. And in my previous precision farming videos, I noticed the glitches started to happen with the workers doing random weird stuff from the Twilight Zone type stuff, which was very interesting and fun to watch. And around the third harvest is when glitches weird stuff starts to happen with precision farming. Now, there was an update a few days ago. Hopefully, maybe that addressed those issues. I don't know. I haven't tested it yet. But those were fun to watch. It was fun to find out. I really enjoyed that. But we're going to continue to let this worker do its thing. And I'm almost out of wheat. I've got 16%, but that should be hopefully enough for the rest of this field. And as you can see, I'm using the fertilizer that is, you know, for this cedar. But the next thing I'm going to do today is add manure to this and see if I can make those lighter green splotches in the sandy loam match up. And when I come back to this, when we come back to this, I want to see if those splotches changed at all. So now it's making one. I want to see if there's any more variances. All the fields have that. Now I'm going to go to back to here, show the soil types as I just, you know, as I discussed. It's mostly sandy loam. But for the purposes of this video, we're looking at nitrogen and adding manure. Oh, wow, look at those splotches. You see on the far right here, let me do my circle cursor. That is cool. That's what I was looking for. So this is a new discovery with precision farming that I've found out as I'm recording this now. And I thought I needed to start recording it because I thought this needs to be documented. So I'm going to add manure to that and see if it evens it out. Oh yeah, this is definitely a cool test video for what I think the manure, when I hire a worker, it's going to spread out where it needs to and clean that up. Go pick up that manure spreader. Continuing talking about the horses. Don't worry, this video, I hope, has entertained you so far. There's a lot to talk about. There's a lot to show. I also need to, for those that are new, here you are, to my channel. As you can see, I'm on 9 days per season. Everything's turned on. Everything's turned on. Crop damage is at 50. Weed intensity scale is at 20. And I believe that's the default. And that, believe me, that is enough for immersion. Well, you will have weeds to deal with. It will make it fun for you. If you want to put it on 100 to be hardcore, that would be cool, just to see. Well, I think I've covered everything. It looks like I need to do some more plant seeding over there where the worker wasn't able to go to. That's okay. I won't worry about that. I'll spread the manure out where I've already got it all set up to go, where the big splotches are that we saw earlier. So I'm driving to the shop to pick up the manure spreader. It's time for some more driving music. Sell this. Maybe I need an old-time tractor. Awesome, awesome. Okay, onward. Now, let me just look at this in the garage. Because I really didn't read it. Manure spreaders improve the harvest of your fields. Okay, so this is definitely a manure spreader. Of course it is. Of course it is. I just don't see any options to unfold it. So that's what I got worried about. No, nothing up there in the controls. So once I put manure in there, it should work. Or... I will get the options once I'm on my land. That's what I'm thinking. Don't forget to hit the like button, by the way, please. Taking the scenic route. Thought I was gonna hit it, didn't you? Yeah, that windmill's got a lot of clearance. All right, here we are. The manure in my multi-fruit silo station, which I know manure is not a fruit. There, 7,984. And the garage says to me that this is a lizard manure spreader that holds everything under the sun. What? How do I get manure in there? Did it have to be the trailer version? Oh, wait a minute. Okay, wait a second. Hold on a second. I'm sorry. Duh. There's this mod. Awesome. I did not know this. I have not seen this before. hats off to the person who made this. This is cool. Apparently, this can be two different types of trailers. A manure trailer, which holds 3,500, or a trailer itself, which holds grain or whatever you want. I get it. But the good news, I don't have to drive to the shop over there because I got my own little area right here. Looks like I gotta get that milling machine out of the way. Bear with me. Get this out of the way real quick. Oh yeah, I just repaired this and then washed it off because I'm done with this right now for the season. I don't need this anymore. This is a good spot. Alright then. I just need to switch it back. Okay, I get it. Everybody was probably wondering and probably saying to themselves as they were watching me, they already knew. Alright, so now we're going to customize this. Right there, standard configuration, 3,500 liters of manure. Alright then, customize. $0, yes, okay. Jump back in here. Drive back over to the grain silo. By the way, I do want to show you that I do have manure growing. I have manure growing. That's interesting. That's an interesting way of putting it. My cows, you saw, so I had some. So I won't be buying it every time. It's going to be free fertilizer. There's a big pile of it over there. So I got two bulls. There's one of them. There we are. Nice big old pile of manure. The bulls are not breedable yet. They're still a little bit young. I imagine they'll be able to breed in about 3 days, 3 or 4 days of game time. Or about mid-fall. Alright, now the purpose of this whole video was to see what the nitrogen, if doing this will clean up the nitrogen after three harvests, planting a fourth, soon to be a harvest, as you can see as I showed on my crop rotation planner, letter A, and then B, C, and D are also ones that I'm currently working on. You can pause that and look at it if you'd like. Here we are. So, I like this mod. I really do. I thought it was just going to be temporary, but I'm going to keep it. Then I'm also going to invest in the large... Let me show you. I'm going to make a future video about it. This one is so cool. It's under crop protection. And it's this. The Terragator, which holds 45,000 liters of manure. Wow, that is a beast. I can't wait for, and I'm going to load that up with my wheel loader. That's going to be fun. That is so cool. Heck yeah. H-E-C-K. You know, you don't want to say certain words. Gotta watch for the purposes of this. Alright. Now I should need to open this up here. It should show me. I'm gonna go to the spot where I saw the most, where it could possibly mostly need it, and then that will hopefully then clean all of that up. Now I'm not gonna get back and I'm not gonna do the I'll do that on my own time. Here we are. Okay, pay attention to the lower left-hand corner of the screen. It looks like it is definitely working. It is getting darker. That is very cool indeed. It's better than I realized. I thought the worker was just going to spread it around. As we can see where it says pH value, we're not looking at that. We're looking at nitrogen. 180, and this is sandy loam. I wonder if it'll... If this is now going to say 200. Okay, now it says 180 perfect. What does it say now? 180 perfect. But it's a little bit better than perfect because, as we saw... Hold on a minute. There it is. It's actually getting a darker shade of green, which ultimately means better yield. And what I'm really liking is the spreader. I've only used 7% on two passes. Wow, this mod is awesome. This mod is a 5-star. I had no idea how awesome it was. I'm glad I downloaded it. If anybody wants to know, so you don't have to back up, so you can get it too. It's the Lizard N-235/1. You can convert it to a manure spreader, which the spread on that is amazing. It's not using very much. Other spreaders, manure spreaders I've seen, really go through that manure fast, not as efficiently. But even though the meter spread is only 4 meters, that's not bad at all. I was thinking maybe 2 or 3, but very nice, very nice. So, precision farming now, this is the next way to go. Once you've done 3 harvests, go ahead and get yourself some manure out. Actually, do it after the 2nd harvest. I should have done it after the canola. I'm talking about rotation plan A. So about every 2 harvests, so it's going to be, now I've got the wheat, I'm catching up. It's all evening it out. It's very pretty, isn't it? I think that covers everything. I'm glad I recorded this. I'm glad I took mental note to record this. And I just want to make sure I've got everything, you know, necessary so that this video gives you as much information as you need. The yields are pretty much standard every harvest. That just depends on the soil type. The darker the green, the better. This is loamy sand. Loamy sand, loamy sand. I haven't harvested this yet. We got some barley over here that I need to harvest yet. I also need to harvest some canola that's right here. You know, let's go ahead and take a look at that too before this video ends. Now the weeds, I take care of my, there's hardly ever any weeds on my property. It's just a little bit there. I spread a herbicide spreader every time. And the herbicide spreader that I use, in case you're wondering, the spread on it is very nice. It's worth the money. This one here. And make sure you get the one that goes 10 miles per hour. There's one that goes 7 miles per hour, and then there's the one that goes 10. That's what makes this mod the best mod for spreading herbicide in the game, in my opinion. Herbicide, okay? Wow, I've only used 20% manure. And I've got, I'd say, 20% of the field, so that's cool. For only 3,500 liters? Oh yeah, and then it was only about 10 slots? This mod is awesome. Okay, let's go back to fruit types that I've shown. I just harvested this and this, but it still shows what it was. It was oats, a little bit of oats that was there. They're not there now. Corn is still growing. Here is some more wheat that will be still growing. Here's some more wheat that's still growing. A lot of wheat. I got to keep up with those chickens and then the pigs, of course, that'll be coming. A little bit of canola. I'm sitting pretty good on canola. Let's look at that. I don't really sell crops. The only crops I sell are soybeans and sunflowers. Canola I save strictly for my pigs whenever I have them. And as you can see, I almost have 36,000 canola sitting in my grain silo. Corn, 39,000, more on the way. Corn is the main staple for pigs in seasons. If you don't have corn, don't even worry about having pigs. You got to have enough corn. And then the corn, to get pigs at 100% health, give them canola, and then give them wheat or barley. Sell, don't never give them your soybeans. It's worth more to sell them at the highest market value, and never sell your, never give your pigs your sunflowers. Canola, hands down, is the only one that, you know, to get your pigs at 100% health. Corn will keep them at 80% health. Your pigs will stay at 80%, but they won't get any higher. Next, you need wheat, barley, and canola, respectively, to jump them up to 100. And I do not want to use, well, that was interesting. That's what I thought it would do too. I thought it would kind of spread and stop, which it did. So it definitely had a reason for doing that. Oh, it's because it was at 200. Awesome. So, all right, I'm glad I stuck around and kept recording, because that's important. It's not gonna go over 200. So the possibility of over-fertilizing over 200 has now been officially declared that you cannot do it. Maybe. You know, I don't know. What if I spread slurry next on this? Would that cause it to be over-fertilized and make this like a value nitrogen of like 220, 240? Maybe I need to test that out. But I give my cows straw, and the reason is, to end this video, I give my cows straw for manure, because the output per 4,000 liters of straw is you're gonna get more manure for it. If you give your pigs straw, you're losing out. Never give your pigs straw unless you got so much straw you don't know what to do with. Which probably I think I will be eventually get to that point. Then of course, you know, but if you're just a farmer starting out, stay away from giving pigs straw. They consume it way too quickly because they breed too quickly. They breed very, very fast. And then the young piglets the next day, the next morning, will consume straw just like an adult would. But of course, but they don't make as much manure. That's just a little glitch in the game that I have noticed, and one you should take note of. Whether or not you want to give them straw or not, just make note of that, you know. Make, you know, I thought I would mention that too. Stuff that I've learned. All right, so if you've been watching up to this point, I really appreciate you sticking around. That was you're a very cool person. Only about 10 to 20% of you who watch my videos actually stick around this far. And the number might even be less than that. The longer the video is, of course. And that's cool. I'm not saying that's bad, but I really appreciate you sticking around. I hope I've given you enough information to have earned your subscription. And please leave a like, and if you'd like to also, please leave a comment. I like to, whenever I make a precision farming video, I like to cover as much as possible, show people what I'm doing, because there's a lot to know. I am also curious what the economic values are for this. Okay. I've only harvested so far this field and this field. So, and it was oats on both. That's cool. So I have a hypothetical profit of 14,904. That's not set in stone. It will go up higher than that because I'm using the oats for horses. So that's going to definitely turn into a huge more profits. And I actually had to grow, as you can see, I've got 23,159 liters of oats. That should be enough to last me quite a while for my horses. Horses need oats, just like pigs need corn with seasons. And then they also need hay and straw. The horses are a lot of work. What else can I show everybody as I'm talking and discussing things, what my plans are? This one should show, okay, I was going to say zero, because I have not harvested anything yet this year. The corn is still growing, the wheat is still growing, and then the barley I'm harvesting today later on. that minus 42 will go up. And that's why is it at minus 42? That ain't vehicle maintenance and fuel. Well, that's cool. It actually, it'll tell you which property number where your vehicles had wear and tear. That's cool. That's a cool discovery. What is the vehicle maintenance here? 620, of course, because I've been harvesting all day. And right now it is 1:27 p.m. It's going to take me about 2 hours to ride the rest of the horses. That will be in a future video. If I was to make a guess, how about 32,000 for my profits for riding those horses in one day? If it's higher than or lower than that, we'll see. 32,000 would make it worth it. Okay, I think that pretty much covers things. Oh yeah, we need to one more time jump inside this tractor where the worker was. It is now me. It is me now, but the worker is working for me. I actually am not doing anything. So it has definitely made it so there's more nitrogen in the soil naturally. Manure is good. Manure is one of your best fertilizing types. And I'm still at less. I'm not even at 50% left yet. And I've, yeah, I think I was right. This, I think this 3,500 liters is going to do this entire field. Wow. That makes this mod 5 stars. If I could give it 10, I would. One last thing. Whoops. Accidentally. There we are. Let's do a landscape view to show everybody what is going on with my design. See here, I'm gonna have future roads here that I'm gonna paint. There'll be another painting video coming up, probably in about a week. And then I've got all these fields going on. I've established a farm now. I've got all the animals almost. I'll have pigs. Then I need sheep. With sheep, I'm gonna have to go like big time on sheep because the profit margins are very low. I've had 80 sheep is the most I've ever had. That mod that gives you up to 80 sheep. Profit margins are low, so I'm gonna have to go with 500 sheep, but that requires a lot more investment first in getting ready. I need more hay. So everything's going in the correct order. Can look around some more. Just give everybody an idea of what's been going on. Give you know some catch up. What do you think of the roads that I painted? After I made that painting video, I took the time and actually did some more touch up. It took me about another hour. And it looks like I need to finish because I just purchased this land. You know, to make room for the horses. So actually, I could actually finish this up. If anybody has stuck around to this far, up to this point, wants to watch me paint a little bit to connect these two roads. Because before I couldn't do it because I didn't own that property. So that's a quick cleanup. Oh yeah, a little bit too much. I got to add some grass. But do click the like. Maybe that's what I meant to say. Click that like button, okay? There, that looks really cool. Everybody have a great day.